Hello everyone, it's wonderful to see you all again. Today, I will guide you on how to generate a report in the report creator of AutoCAD Plant 3D, where all the pipe run components and fasteners are grouped by their line number tag. Let's begin. First, open your project in the Project Manager. Then, open the project setup. Go to Plant 3D DWG settings, then to Plant 3D class definitions. In the piping and equipment, we need to create a new property for the P3D line group tag. Click the Add button. In the Add Property dialog, enter the property name and display name as demonstrated in the video. Note that you can choose any name you prefer. I will use line number group for this example. Next, set the type to acquisition and click OK. In the Select Data Source dialog, find P3D line group under categories. Select it and then choose tag from the properties on the right. Click OK to close the Select Data Source dialog and then click OK again to close the Add Property dialog. Finally, click OK to save your settings and exit the project setup. Now search for Report Creator of AutoCAD Plant 3D in Windows and open the application. In the Report Creator, browse under Projects and select the project.xml file for the project where you added the new property, line number group. In the report configuration, select 3D parts from the drop-down menu. Below, choose either project data or drawing data based on your requirements. Click the Edit button in the report configuration section. In the report configuration dialog, click the Edit Query button. In the Query configuration dialog, select Plant 3D classes as the query type. Look for the class Fasteners in the available classes, select it, and click the arrow to add it to the Included Class section. Ensure that all necessary piping components are included in the Included Classes section. If any are missing, please add them using the same method we used for adding fasteners previously. Click OK to save your changes. Next, click the Edit Report Layout button. A Report Designer dialog box will appear. Select No here. Then, navigate to the View tab in the menu bar. In the ribbon of the View tab, find Windows. Click the Windows drop-down and choose Field List. Again, click the Windows drop-down and select Group and Sort. This will display the field list and group and sort palettes. Remove any unnecessary properties already present in the group header. Now, in the Field List palette under Data, locate the Engineering Items line number group property that we created earlier. Select and drag the Engineering Items line number group property into the group header, as demonstrated in the video. Next, let's set up the grouping in the Group and Sort palette. In the default report template, you will find the Engineering Items short description field listed in the Group and Sort palette. Click on the drop-down for Engineering Items, Short Description, and locate the property we created earlier called Engineering Items Line Number Group. Select the Engineering Items Line Number Group field and click the Move button to position it at the top of the Group and Sort section. Note: this step is applicable if you have set the tag format under P3D line group. If you have set the tag format under pipe run component tag, use the pipe run component tag property in the group header instead, as shown in the video. Now, save and close the report designer. Here comes the tricky part. In report configuration, click the drop-down to change the report template. A dialog box will appear asking, "Current report configuration has been modified. Do you want to save the changes?" Click Yes. Note: if you skip this step, your report settings will not be saved. Additionally, Remember that the report template files are stored in the app data folder. Make sure you have the necessary permissions to read and write these files. You can now successfully generate reports grouped by the line number tag as intended. That's all for today's episode. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Make sure to hit that bell icon so you never miss an update on latest videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time.